So chances are if you're surfing the web on your Mac, you're doing it with Safari, which is the built-in web browser, and that's what most people use. It's what I use. But there are other options. The browser wars are still going on, and there are two major browsers that other Mac users use. So we have Safari, and that just comes with your Mac. Another browser you can get is Chrome. So Chrome is from Google, and it shares a lot of the same code that Safari does, the open source part, the part that renders web pages and things like that. So you're going to find that pages look very similar, if not identical, whether you use Google Chrome or you use Safari. So what's the advantage? Well, the advantage using Chrome is if you're using the Google ecosystem, in other words, you're using Google's cloud services, maybe you also have an Android phone, maybe you've got a Windows machine and you're using Chrome there, since it's the most popular browser on Windows, you can then share things like passwords and bookmarks and all of that using your Google account. So if you want cross-platform compatibility, then you might want to use Chrome on each browser, on each operating system. You can't use Safari on Windows anymore, so you're kind of stuck using something like Chrome across. You can, of course, just use Safari on Mac and Chrome on Windows. That's fine. But if you want to have information available across those platforms, using Chrome might be a good way to do it. Another browser that you can use is Firefox. And Firefox is in the news recently because they just came out with a new version of the Firefox browser. And you can get that for Mac as well. And it has a similar advantage in that you can get Firefox on Windows and on Mac, but it doesn't have quite the market share that Chrome has. Chrome has really become the dominant browser, at least for computers in general, although of course the dominant browser on Macs is clearly Safari, since it comes pre-installed in your Mac and most people don't move beyond that. Now both Chrome, Firefox, and Safari all have extensions, but different extensions are available for each. So if you're a developer, sometimes Firefox can have an extension that you want or need to be able to develop, and the same thing with Chrome. Now Firefox is going to sometimes look a little different than either Chrome or Safari on your Mac because it's rendering things with a little bit different code. But today in 2017, things look pretty much the same, as standards have been around for a long time and the browsers all kind of render the HTML on each web page in the same way. Now one big reason you may want to have multiple browsers available on your machine is that every once in a while you run into a website that doesn't work with Safari. Safari is probably the strictest in terms of security. So it's not giving access to some apps that may want to be able to access things for video conferencing, say, or special security things, or downloading things from certain websites, viewing things using certain plugins. It may not be available on Safari. So having Firefox and Chrome is a good way to have a backup. I've run into a few situations, usually in some pretty select environments, where I've needed to have Chrome available so that I could view a web page or download some content. Now, both Firefox and Chrome are free to download and easy to download, and they can live right alongside Safari in your applications folder. So it doesn't hurt to have them sitting there just for such an occasion. Getting these apps is pretty easy. For Chrome, just go to google.com/Chrome or just search for Chrome Mac. Firefox, the same kind of thing. Mozilla.org is where you want to go, and then there's a download link right there. You can also just search for Get Firefox and you'll find it as the top link. So you can just download either of these for free, have them available. Both also have mobile versions that you can get for iOS. So you can add Chrome and you can add Firefox as alternative browsers to have on your iPhone or iPad as well. Now for the typical Mac user, you're not going to need anything but Safari. But if you do use Chrome or Firefox on your Mac, I'd love to hear why you use it. So leave a comment here at macmost.com and let me know why you prefer or why you sometimes occasionally have to use Firefox or Chrome.